Gustavo, you know, he all about that get back now. And I think this was episode, you know, he kind of have his own little single. I wouldn't say it's a single episode, but I kind of felt like this episode was kind of geared around him and him trying to get retribution for his cousin, you know what I'm saying, getting stabbed up over that 100K from Fuentes.
Yeah, definitely. You know, what I didn't see was Fuentes was actually the chief. You know what I mean? I thought he was a different dude. You know what I mean? So
another El Chapo type guy that was running things behind the scene.
Right. Cause you know, when I found out it was actually the chief, it kind of was like, ah man, that's a little too easy. It seemed like it was a little too easy to get to him. You know what I mean? Like they did hit him Teddy Reed. Yeah. Teddy Reed had the sniper kind of, but I'm like, man, kind of got to him a little easy, but yeah, it was Gustavo had to get that get back, man. Gustavo had to get that get back.
It was a play through the Mexican police though, because was it the DFS or something like that? They were looking, you know, saying go ahead, wrap Fuentes up too. So this was an opportunity for them to kind of team up with the CIA to go ahead and get and take him out. Because you know, when they went into the office, they was more or less already had all the paperwork set up. They kind of had his secret hideout where he was out to. So Gustavo basically had to just get a plan to get him to run to the isolated crib. And when Gustavo, he a real hero, man. He just walked in. When anytime you see somebody with the black hoodie and the black gloves on, you know it's about to go down.
Know it's about to go down. Cause that was a dead giveaway. When he walked in, I'd be like, hold up, man. He up in here for he ain't for no good. Whatever he got going on ain't no good.
No good. He coming there with the black gloves and the hoodie. You already know what time it is. So he going there, catch Fuentes, catch his boy right up on the staircase. Throw him off the top of the staircase.
Etched the 100,000 in the forehead.
Don't get to him. He was like, I know he had a plan from the jump. He like, hey, look, I know how to get him out to the crib. I can get him moved. So I got a plan. Don't worry about it. And Reed sitting there, he's like, man, what are you talking about? He's like, man, I'll be right back. Don't worry about it.
Man, Reed be like, man, these cats don't never go with a plan. They just go off the cuff. Be like, you know what? I'm about to go in here and let them have it, you know? And Reed like, look, man, we got to keep it discreet, man. We still got a business to run. But yeah, Gustavo was like, nah, he killed family. Kids is orphans now. He got to pay.
You got to go. We got to. He said, man, I'm with you to the end of the line. Just more or less, we got to get him back. You know what I'm saying? We just got to get him back. Got to get retribution basis. So, you know, that was his plan. I felt like this episode was a lot geared for him for kind of, you know, get that retribution for his killing of his cousin and his wife, his cousin's wife. And then, like I said, for the kids and all that good stuff. So I thought that when he was sitting in the front room, when Reed came to the door, I thought it was going to be somebody else. You know what I mean? I thought he was sitting there
waiting for somebody. Yeah.
But it ended up being Reed. So I guess he told Reed what was happening, blah, blah, blah. He showed up. You know, I thought they were going to get the bodies, kind of go, you know, take care of the bodies and all that. But, you know, Gustavo, you know, he finna go solo. He thought he going to just go take on the man solo, jump in the truck, pull off.
Man, that man about to try to walk in the police station and shoot everybody, man. I was like, hold on, man.
He did haul off, hit him in the head, knocked him out.
Man, hit him with the gun butt. Bah! Hey, calm down, bro. You know?
I'm with the CIA, man. We do things a little different around here, man.
Yeah, you can't go out here. You can't go out here acting like it's Call of Duty, man. Just go out there.
Gustavo knew he was a CIA agent. I thought Gustavo knew that though. You know, even from last season when they walked in on him when he was in the warehouse I think Gustavo shot the agent that was with Reed. So I thought he knew at that point that the guy was a CIA agent.
Nah, because I knew he didn't know Reed was a agent when he shot the undercover and didn't shoot Reed. Because at that time, I felt like if he'd have knew, he'd have shot Reed too. You know what I mean? But maybe not, because Reed was supplying the dope, so he might have would have thought twice about it. Like, man, you know what I mean? But, huh?
He said, I can't kill a plug. You're like, I can't kill a plug.
Yeah, I can't kill the plug. So that's, I mean, but when he told him, you know what I mean? You know, he started running everything back. It's like, man, it made sense. Like, damn, this dude, every day you coming too easy for this cat. You know, white dude, what do you call him, gringo? You know what I mean? He just got the plug. He like, got the, then he was like, Yeah, he like, man, got the, yeah, he got the dope, got the guns. He's then we start thinking about it all. He like, damn, like, I know he, it seemed like he was like, man, how did I not see that, man? This dude, you know, got it all. Yep. Like, easy. Like, this dude just walking around, just him, like, you know what I mean? But
almost.
Yeah, yep, exactly, exactly. So, it to me, it's like, it's going to be interesting to see now, because, you know, what Gustavo said, I wish you to be killed, dude.
Yeah,
so, I'm like, now what? You know what I mean? Now what he gonna do? Cause they he done killed him. And Gustavo was like, "What you gonna do now? You gonna go at? Or you gonna try to sever ties with Reed? He the plug.
He the plug. You know what I mean? And he you got know? The going because without Reed, he ain't really have no work. He ain't got no dope. He can't do nothing. So do you know, nothing. Reed the middleman. He the plug. So he got everything set up. But you know, just moving forward, just talking, we just seeing how we see Franklin kind of come back, kind of try to set things straight with the dirty cop, you know what I'm saying? Let him know, you know, he's sitting down almost like Denzel Washington and gangsters at the table trying to eat his food, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He set the scene, he come in, he sit down and, you know, he tried to let him know, hey, look, man, don't come to my family like that no more. Cause you know, his dad, he basically pressed his dad up in the business. And he was like, look, man, you had an opportunity to, you know, get me back then. That was 4 months ago, but man, you took the bread. So this what it bread. Is.
So yeah, that's what it is. And then he doubled down and went at his mom's. I'm like, bruh, he would not just go at his mom's. He walked in their house. You know, walked in their house, took his mom's out. I'm like, come on, bruh. You know what I mean? He lucky that's all that happened, that he sent him to what, office duty or what they call, what they sent him to? Investigations or whatever.
Evidence locker.
Yeah, like I thought Franklin was about to, put his head on the platter. Like, all right. You gonna throw my mom down, bang her head a couple times. You know what I mean?
But you know
ain't Franklin.
Wait, that ain't Franklin though. You know what I'm saying? He moved different. Like most people would get irrational. Even when he was in the crib and he came in, Franklin was like, hey, look, we're gonna take care of Pop. I'm gonna take care of, you know, just calm, be calm right now. Cause most people wanna go get the pistol load up, go shoot the police. Now you got the whole, you know, LAPD. Now you're making a whole situation behind it when you got a cop.
Now he blew a spot up.
Yeah, you got a cop kill in the black neighborhood. You know, you're already hustling. And people don't really probably know you downtown yet. You know what I mean? As we see that the reporter, you know, he caught a body and they basically covered up. Reed got it all covered up, got it expunged. He's not even in it because the reporter's like, he's like, man, how do you, you know, he was, the reporter later was talking to the guy who arrested him. Like, how do you have not no reports on this? And he's like, man, I arrested him. I brought him downtown. So I know it happened. And so. Yeah. Being able to have that pull like that with him, you know, firing off and shooting him in the black neighborhood, it was gonna blow up the whole spot. So he just kept his cool.
I think he's
back to kind of thinking that two steps ahead. He's like, man, I know how to get him at a different way. I got to get this guy a different way.
Yeah, he do. Yeah, he had to get him different way, and it probably was the best way. You know, like you said, you know, he still was able to move. He's still able to move and do what he do without blowing the spot up. But you know, went a roundabout way. Like you said, moms went to, what is it?
Real estate investor guy.
Real estate investor. Yeah, the real estate investor, which I don't know. That dude, I think that dude gonna do something.
He looks shiesty. And so what happened was I think that, you know, that's a play that she's trying to do. She's trying to maneuver and trying to get at Scully in a different type of way. You know what I'm saying? Because they've been trying to go at it, you know, bang it up in the streets. But she's like, look, let's try to move different. You know what I'm saying? Let's go on the real estate avenue. Let's try to do a political where she's more or less trying to get them blocks and then trying to get his whole building. Because what happened, he's basically, Scully fortified himself in that whole building. He got the whole block sold up. He got the whole compound, the whole, you know, the whole complex sold up with all
that shit like the Carter out there.
Yeah, the Carter. So he can't get to him. So what you do is you buy the block out and then you force him out. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You expose him. Yep. And so, like I said, they're playing in a different league. Now, I don't want to say different league, but they're just playing at a different angle where Skull and them just trying to come straight at you, shoot you down, gun you down, that type.
I think that angle going to take too long. It's going to take too long. Yeah. You know what I mean? Scully going to be coming for him way before they're able to do that. Way before they're able to buy them blocks up and play the political role and get them out of there. And man, Scully gonna be done, did about two or three, four drive by through the house by that time. You know what I mean?
load up with the pistol, because you already know what he about. He come with that. He got the rifles. He got the guns. He got the manpower. He finna come at Franklin, because especially when Franklin don't got Leon on the team no more. You know what I'm saying? So you already know he can go get
out. Leon about to get caught up too, man. Leon about to get caught up, man.
He got Wanda. He out there. He still got, you see Wanda. They finally brought Wanda back.
Yeah, man. You see, he still got feelings for Wanda, man. Wanda out there just, she all the way gone, bro.
Up, she crack her head up.
Man, he's still saving her. Hey, man, you know these niggas don't play out here. Man, you better let Wanda go, bro. What's wrong with you, bro? You see what Wanda? Hey, Lily, nigga, if you, man, come on, bro. What's wrong with you, man?
She fine out here in them streets.
Man, he, man.
Like, man, I ain't feeling right, Leon. Y'all stepping on that dope too much, man. Yeah, it's the
niggas ain't knowing Leon ain't got that plug no more. Leon about to be like, that's why I say Leon about to get caught up. Leon gonna be like, he gonna have to go back to Franklin, or he gonna do some other shit. The thing about it,
I wanna let him go back. I don't think it's pride. I wanna let him go back though. That's what it is.
That's what I'm saying. But I'm like, nigga, why don't you cook it up yourself, bro? You was there when he was cooking it. You know how to cook it.
But he don't,
like, why?
He don't have to cook though. That's the thing. He gotta.
That's true. Yeah.
That's the whole thing. You know what I'm saying?
He gonna fuck him around. I think he gonna try to go over Franklin. Yeah, he gonna try to go to Reed, cause he met Reed a couple times.
Yeah, when they first got on, you know Reed.
Yeah.
But I don't know if Reed trusts him like that though. Reed don't really rock with a lot of different people. Like if Franklin don't give him the stamp, I don't think Reed'll rock with him.
Yeah, I don't know, man. Reed be about that money. I think if you know, Leon be like, hey, I got these projects sold up. This is my, you know what I mean? I got the money. I think Reed might, and then Reed know him. Like, he don't know him like that, like you said, but you know what I mean? I think he'll mess, because what Franklin gonna do? So if-